السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله. أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله. أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله. حي على الصلاة. حي على الصلاة. حي على الفلاح. حي على الفلاح. الله أكبر الله أكبر. لا
إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستهديه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله تعالى من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، إنه من يهده الله فهو المهتد ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا. الحمد لله رب العالمين والعاقبة للمتقين ولا عدوان إلا على الظالمين، ولا إله إلا الله إلهنا وإله الأولين والآخرين وقيوم السماوات والأرضين، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، له الملك وله الحمد، يحيي ويميت وهو على كل شيء قدير، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله وصفيه من خلقه وحبيبه، أرسله الله تبارك وتعالى رحمةً للعالمين وإمامًا للمتقين وحجةً علينا نحن الخلائق أجمعين، فاللهم صلِّ وسلِّم وبارِك عليه وعلى آله وصحبه ومن تبعهم بإحسانٍ إلى يوم الدين. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفسٍ واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، إخوة الإسلام، فها نحن في اليوم الخامس من المدرسة الثانوية التي تأتي إلينا بمنهج بسيط يتحصل منه المسلم على أعلى الدرجات في التقوى والمغفرة وعلى شهادة معتمدة من رب العالمين بالعتق من النيران إن شاء الله تعالى. So my dear brothers and listening sisters, today is number 5, the 5th of Ramadan. Few more days and you will find me greeting you and saying Eid Mubarak. That's the nature with Ramadan. But when you are in the 5th day of Ramadan and 4 or 5 days already passed, you're going to think, or you have to think about this school. And I'm talking again, alhamdulillah rabbil alameen, to the people of education. People who believe in the importance of education in our life. A school for 30 days, from which you get a degree of taqwa, a degree of forgiveness, and a certificate from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that you are, insha'Allah ta'ala, from the people of Jannah. And your neck, insha'Allah, will be free from the hellfire. Very simple curriculum that you have to do. It's fasting. As we said last week, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا كُتِبَ عَلَيْكُمُ الصِّيَامُ. So, fasting is prescribed upon you. It is obligatory at the end of the day. But when you enter that school with that intention, the intentions that we talked about last week, you're gonna come out of this school with this or these degrees that I just mentioned. But عن أي صيام نتحدث؟ عن صيام البطن وصيام الفرج ثم بعد ذلك لا نبالي أم هو صيام أشمل وأعم من هذا الصيام الذي يصومه معظم المسلمين. So about which fasting we're talking? Somebody is fasting, abstaining from food, drink, touching the wife the whole day. That's it. And then beyond this, he is looking at the haram. He is talking about the haram. He is handling and dealing with the haram. Or we're talking about fasting that more general than this particular fasting that we know. So just to set it before I start, when you fast from the dawn until the sunset, and I have a quick reminder at the end, inshallah, about the sunset issue, because we're still getting the questions about that. At the end, inshallah, I'll talk about it. To fast from dawn until the sunset, your fasting is, inshallah, valid. Is it acceptable or not? It's up to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But are you getting the reward for it as you are promised or not? It's your call. You have to add and accompany this fasting that we do with more types and areas of fasting that you have to observe during the month of Ramadan. لأن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال في الحديث الصحيح الذي رواه سيدنا أبو هريرة أورد الإمام البخاري في صحيحه يقول صلى الله عليه وسلم من لم يدع قول الزور والعمل به والجهل فليس لله حاجة في أن يدع طعامه وشرابه. So think of it this way. Somebody is torturing, and I'm saying it clearly, torturing himself from the Fajr until the Maghrib, from the first day of Ramadan until the last day of Ramadan. No food, no drinks, he is torturing himself. But deep in his heart, he's not caring about it. He doesn't care about all the areas of fasting that has to observe. Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said about this person, and I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala not to make any of us from those people. Because, and Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said that, whoever does not give up the false statement, acting upon it, and ignorance in Ramadan, there is no need for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that he, of his fasting, that this person leaves his food and drink. You know, it's not about food and drink. It's more than this. It's deeper than this. It's beyond this limit that we're thinking of. That's why the ulama, they said, if you don't perfect your siyam, which is not only, as I said, the food and drink, if you don't perfect your siyam, you're not getting the full ajr. It actually decreases the reward of your siyam. Ya akhi, you're fasting anyway. Why don't you think about protecting and guarding your fasting? And this is our topic for today. How should I protect and guard my fasting during the day and even the night of Ramadan? Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam in a different hadith, he said, رُبَّ صَائِمٍ. Hadith رواه الإمام أبو هريرة أورده ابن ماجة في سننه يقول صلى الله عليه وسلم رب صائم ليس له أو من صيامه أو لم لا حظه من صيامه إلا الجوع والعطش. Perhaps a fasting person, that's another hadith, authentic hadith. Perhaps a fasting person has nothing of his fasting except hunger and thirst. That's all what he gets. He's not taken any of the things that we talked about last week, at-taqwa, forgiveness, the al-itq bin al-niran. He's not getting all of this because he's not giving the main concept of fasting, which is siyam al-jawarih. You want to protect your fasting, you're going to apply your fasting to all of your limbs, to all of your organs. And this is very important to observe. Alhamdulillah, it's only 5 days. We still have 25 days to go, inshallah ta'ala. So, awalan, qala al-ulama, الإنسان عليه أن يراعي في صيامه صيام اللسان. لذلك النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول من لم يدع قول الزور والعمل به. والنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول قول الزور، لم يقل الغيبة، ولم يقل النميمة، ولم يقل الكذب، ولم يقل البهتان، ولم يقل الافتراء، ولم يقل التحدث بالكلام البذيء الفاحش، وإنما قال صلى الله عليه وسلم قول الزور، كل ما خالف الحقيقة. أي شيء غير حقيقة وغير شرعي لأن يقال فهو من أقوال الزور التي على الإنسان أن يتجنبها في رمضان، في بيئة العمل، في البيت، مع الأصحاب، مع الأصدقاء، في المسجد. النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يوجهك توجيها صريحا أن الله تعالى ليس في حاجة منك أن تصوم ليل نهار دون أن تحجم أو دون أن يعني تضع حدا للسانك. So the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, when you talk about the first type of the limbs fasting, your tongue. You guys remember the hadith of Sayyidina Mu'adh ibn Jabal رضي الله عنه, in which he asked the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, يعني are we accountable for what we say? In our tongues, it's only our limbs and our deeds. He said صلى الله عليه وسلم يا معاذ وهل يكب الناس في النار على وجوههم إلا حصائد ألسنتهم. He told Mu'adh, he told you and I that ya Mu'adh, nothing will get the people والعياذ بالله on their faces to the hellfire except the fruits of their tongues. That's why the ulama, they said you're gonna observe fasting of your tongue. He said صلى الله عليه وسلم, whoever does not give up the false statement. And here is, he didn't say صلى الله عليه وسلم backbiting only. He didn't say صلى الله عليه وسلم the slandering some people, using the bad language, talking badly about the people, using words that it's not ethical or moral that to be used. He said a word to include and to have all of these words that people might use and they don't pay attention to it within or during the month of Ramadan. Whoever does not give up. So if you are that person that you are afflicted with using the bad language outside Ramadan, here is the school. Here is the training for yourself to get out of this for 30 days. And if you abstain from that for 30 days, inshallah ta'ala, after Ramadan, you're going to be stronger and you're going to be, inshallah ta'ala, quitting that forever, inshallah ta'ala. Hatta anna Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, not only that you initiate. He said sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that even if you have to react, do not react. You are a fasting person. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam yaqul, إِذَا كَانَ صَوْمُ يَوْمِ أَحَدِكُمْ. When you are fasting, فَلَا يَرْفُثْ وَلَا يَصْخَرْ. Everybody knows that I shouldn't have the relationship with the wife while I'm fasting, and I shouldn't like get into a fight or a dispute or a disagreement or argument with somebody. Fine. But what about if I have to react with a Muslim or non-Muslim? It doesn't matter. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam yaqul, فَإِنْ سَابَهُ أَحَدُ أَمْ شَيَتَبَهُ وَفِي رِوَاءَ أَوْ قَاتَلَهُ. Even somebody is insulting you or trying to pick a fight with you. All what you have to say, إِنِّي صَائِمٌ إِنِّي صَائِمٌ. The Prophet ﷺ is teaching us how to even control our reaction within the month of Ramadan. Training, it's a workshop to control yourself and to control your anger. If somebody gets you to a limit that you want to react, remember that very well, that I'm a fasting person. I'm fasting, as the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam told us in the authentic hadith. So number one is fasting of your tongue. You have to observe that. Number two, and we have to be honest with ourselves. We have to be open. Now, either you work at University of Alberta or student or a teacher, or you work in the government, or you work somewhere. At the end of the day, we're dealing with Muslims and non-Muslims. No, yani, you cannot. I cannot say today, everybody take off and forget about your work. Islam says, you know what, you have to protect yourself. You have to lower your gaze. You have to be practical. So, كلنا يعمل مع مسلم وغير مسلم وكلنا يرى غير المسلمين يعني ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله. من واجبات المسلم في هذا الشهر العظيم المبارك أن يحافظ على صيام العينان. To observe fasting of your eyes. It's not that you close your eyes all the time, but listen to this hadith. النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول في حديث صحيح, سيدنا أبو هريرة أيضا يروي هذا الحديث في البخاري, يقول صلى الله عليه وسلم إن الله تعالى كتب على ابن آدم حظه من الزنا, فزنا العينان النظر, وزنا اللسان الكلام, والقلب يتمنى ويشتهي, والفرج يصدق ذلك أو يكذبه. It's you at the end of the day. You're gonna be facing a situation that there is a naked woman in front of you in the streets. Even in our neighborhood, يعني everything is there. You're gonna be facing somebody like they're not Muslim. But what's your obligation as a fasting person? Okay, Sheikh, you know, I have no control on that. يعني some people, they said that you have the first look. Can be 1 hour, can be 2 hours, it's the first look. It's not this. It's you getting deeply in your brain that I cannot do that. And I have to observe that. The Prophet ﷺ said that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has decreed upon the son of Adam or the child of Adam his share of zina. So the zina of the eyes when you look or you glance, the zina of the tongue when you speak, the zina of the heart when you wish and hope, and the private parts at the end either act upon all of this or you say, إِنِّي أَخَافُ اللَّهَ رَبَّ الْعَالَمِينَ. So don't give yourself the option, or don't start by looking. Always think of yourself as a fasting person who has to put a barrier between his eyes and anything haram. And I'm not talking only about looking at women in the street, but in general. And Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam was clear when he said that when you start and you give yourself the permissibility to look, you are putting yourself in danger and nobody knows what's going to happen after that. But as a fasting person, you have to observe that. عليك يعني أن تدرك يقينا بأنه من محسنات صيامك غض البصر وقل للمؤمنين يغضوا من أبصارهم. This is inside Ramadan and outside Ramadan, but what I'm trying to say is this is a school. This is a training session for 30 days, helps you inshallah ta'ala during the rest of the year. So first of all, you have to observe fasting of your tongue, observe fasting of your eyes as much as you can. And number three, fasting of your ears. Fasting of the ears. Like somebody, he loves that. While he's driving to work, coming back from work, always he likes to listen to whatever of this singer or that singer, or that's affliction. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us all hidayah inshallah ta'ala. But some people are afflicted with that. Ramadan comes. It's a great chance for you to stop this and to start something new. Ya akhi, MashaAllah, before the salah, I heard some brothers, MashaAllah, they're reading. Nice recitation, MashaAllah. Listen to the Quran. Get your ears, like, always. Yani, that's what you enjoy in your life, is to listen to Sufa Ismail, to Al-Minshawi, to Al-Husri. That's your norm. That's your natural, our nature. That I want to listen to those people, not to this singer. So Ramadan is a training session for you now to get out of this and to get rid of all of this, not only the songs or this, but sometimes yani, you are in a group and people are backbiting somebody else. Yani, Ibrahim ibn Adham, rahimahullah, it was reported that one day he was invited to a walima, to a dinner. So when he went, one of the people were late, who he was late. They start talking about him. That's our nature. Yeah, you know what? Let's wait until he's waiting, until his wife gives him the permission. Somebody will say, you know what, he's always drive slowly. Somebody will say, you know what, he is like, they start talking about the guy, the lay person. So they said that, one of them, he said, innahu thaqeel, this man is heavy, always comes late. You know what he did, Ibrahim ibn Adham? He threw out the food that he just ate, and he said, ana fa'altu thalika bi nafsi. Samahtu li nafsi an ajlisa fi majlisin yughtabu an-nas fi. I did that for myself. And he left right away, and he said that it was my mistake that I sat with people who backbite other people. So right away, people are doing something, or backbiting, or talking bad about other people, I just leave them, and I find some other place, and I wait away for them, because I'm practicing fasting for my ears, fasting for my tongues, fasting for my eyes, and fasting for my ears, fasting for my hands and legs, and the outmost and the highest level of practicing the real fasting in Ramadan is here. As I said last week, and we had an interview on Monday. This is amazing. Those people, they ask us and they take from you. Don't be careful when you tell somebody, non-Muslim, something about your religion, that it is has a dispute about it, or you're not sure about it, please. So the TV came here and they were interviewing me about Ramadan, and they said that we heard that it is optional. Some Muslims, they told them that it's optional. And some Muslims, they said that you can't take break during Ramadan. You can't take break during Ramadan. And some others, they said that we can break at 6 o'clock. I will talk about this at the end of the khutbah, inshallah, about 6 o'clock. I'm going to shock some people, inshallah. But you know, it's here. I told her, forget about all of this. Fasting is not that we go through the hardship. Fasting is that we are practicing spiritual. Spiritual. Feel it. Yahi, you're going to be thirsty. You're going to be hungry. For sure, you're a human being. But when you look at your heart, are you reaching, are you getting higher in spirituality or not? If you're not, there's something wrong with you. If you still think about food and drink and fasting, and you're not practicing the fasting of the heart, Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said in Hadith Sahih, in Imam Nawawi has a great commentary on this hadith. He said, Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, la tabaghadu. Here is the fasting that you clean and you empty your heart from anything against your Muslim brother. He said, Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, la tabaghadu wa la tahasadu wa kunu ibadallahi ikhwana. This is the ultimate and the utmost level that you can get out of fasting, that your heart is fasting. You are in the masjid and you see a brother, you love him for the sake of Allah. Your home and your family are talking about a family member that there is a problem with. You know what? I forgive them for the sake of Allah. It's Ramadan. My heart is fasting. I don't want to hear anything about them. I don't want to have anything in my heart against my Muslim brother. This is fasting of your heart that you have to achieve at the end of the month, inshallah ta'ala. Practice this. And don't think only about the physical aspect of fasting, which is food and drink and touching the wife. Think beyond this. Think about your eyes, think about your tongue, think about your limbs, all of your limbs, and at the end, think about your heart. Are you fasting or not? And you have to answer, أَقُولُ قَوْلِ هَذَا وَأَسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهَ لِي وَلَكُمْ أُدْعُوا اللَّهَ تَبَارَكَ وَتَعَالَى وَأَنْتُمْ مُوقِنُونَ بِالنَّجَاةِ. الحمد لله وكفى وصلاة وسلاما على عباده الذين اصطفى. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، أشهد أن محمد عبده ورسوله. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. وبعد، my goal before the khutbah, because it's Ramadan and I'm fasting like you, to have the khutbah for 15 minutes, but I can't control myself. Anyway, one thing to conclude with. I was not planning to talk about it at all, because actually sometimes you are advertising that when we talk about it. كثير من الإخوة, and I'm going to be so open and so frank about it, because I'm Egyptian. Not because I'm Egyptian and all Egyptians are honest, but because the fatwa came from Egypt. جاءت هذه الفتوى في عام 2011 من دار الإفتاء المصرية تقول أن الصيام, هو بالعربي وبالإنجليزي, أن الصيام في الأماكن التي تزيد ساعات الصيام فيها على 18 ساعة يجوز لأهل هذه المناطق التقدير بناء على قاعدة. لا تنسوا أن من أفتى بهذه الفتوى هم أساتذتنا, وأنا بالنسبة إليهم هكذا, هم أساتذتي وعلماؤنا, وأنا أتشرف أني أصغر تلميذ لهؤلاء الأساتذة من جامعة الأزهر, ولكن لتعليق قد أخطئ وقد أصيب. أن من يصوم أكثر من 18 ساعة يجوز لهم التقدير على وقت مكة بناء على الحقيقة العلمية. أنا لسه قرأت الفتوى قبل الجمعة, على الحقيقة العلمية التي تقول بأن الصيام لأكثر من 18 ساعة يضر الجسم. وهنا نقل, هل الصيام يضر؟ هل مات أحد منا في إدمنتن من الصيام العام الماضي أو هذا العام ونحن نصوم أكثر من 18 ساعة أم لا؟ لم يمت أحد الحمد لله, لم يتضرر أحد, لم يذهب أحد إلى المستشفى. يا أخي بس في ناس مرضى وفي ناس ما يقدروش يصوموا 18 ساعة, ما عليه صيام أصلا, ليس عليه صيام أصلا إذا كان مريضا. إذا كان من أهل الأعذار عليه أن يفطر من الصباح ولا يصوم أصلا. So the fatwa came as follows. That's why some people in Edmonton, they break their fast at 6 or 7 around that time. They said that the fatwa came from the scholars in Egypt, from Dar al-Ifta, the fatwa, main organization of Ifta in Egypt, saying that the places in the world that you have to fast for more, in which you have to fast for more than 18 hours, you can estimate and fast the time of the hours that the people of Mecca fast, because it is the central of the world, which is around 15 to 16 hours. You're talking about breaking your fast between 6 to 7. Okay? So some people, they act upon this for the last 4 years. I've been trying my best to explain it to them, but everybody follow wherever they want. But why they said that? And those people who issued the fatwa are our teachers, by the way. And we're comparing to them are nothing. When I talk about the scholars of Al-Azhar, I have to be not humble myself, because I'm nothing comparing to them. But the analogy came as follows. They said that because it's proven scientifically that if you fast more than 18 hours, you are harming yourself. And it is gonna be something harmful to the body and might lead to death or something like that. They didn't say death, but it's harmful to the body. Here is the analogy that our teachers used. And because we live in the place, Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us a little of their knowledge. We're saying clearly that we ask the doctors who fast, doctor who fast, because some doctors they don't fast. We ask the doctors about it. Is there a proof to that, that if you fast for more than 18 hours, that it harms your body or not? They said no, there is nothing like that. Even you fast the whole day, you're still going to be okay. So that's number one. We cannot follow the taqdeer or estimation and say that we fast only like the people of Mecca for 15 to 16 hours. We cannot do that. The other thing that they said, that in some places there is no science for Maghrib and Isha and Fajr, so you still can make taqdeer. We have science for Maghrib, we have science for Isha, it's still late, but we still have science, and we have night. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen, it's not that long a night, it's 5 hours. At the end of the day, you still have night. You have day and you have night. So based on this, inshallah ta'ala, and if you have any question about that, you can come ask me after the salah based on this. All the brothers, the Muslim people of Edmonton, they have to fast from dawn, from Al-Fajr, until the sun sets. It sets 10, it sets 9, it sets 8 in winter. Don't forget, for those, I never seen the Ramadan in winter here, but most of you fasted in winter here. In winter, the sun sets at 4. Don't forget that. And that's a privilege for you. You take that. Are you fasting that time according to Mecca, or you fast according to winter? You wanna break your fast at 12 anyway. So it's not pick and choose. It is, alhamdulillah rabbil alameen, we have the science, and it's proven that it's not dangerous, and it's not harmful to your body. Inshallah ta'ala, we don't, again, if you wanna follow that fatwa, it's up to you. But I'm telling you, because I live with you in the same town, I share the same circumstances with you, and I care for you, and I know that some brothers, alhamdulillah, last year, they came and they asked me, and they changed their opinion, and alhamdulillah, they're fasting now. By the time you finish your iftar, it is the real time for iftar. Don't listen to anybody and fast from الفجر حتى غروب الشمس. نسأل الله عز وجل أن يتقبل منا جميعا صيامنا. اللهم تقبل صيامنا. اللهم تقبل صيامنا. اللهم تقبل صيامنا وقيامنا وركوعنا وسجودنا وسائر أعمالنا. اللهم لا تدع لنا في هذا الشهر العظيم دما إلا غفرته، ولا مريضا إلا شفيته، ولا ميتا إلا رحمته، ولا حاجة من حوائج الدنيا لك فيها رضا ولنا فيها صلاح إلا قضيتها ويسرتها لنا يا رب العالمين. نسألك ربنا أن تنصر الإسلام وتعز المسلمين، وأن تعلي بفضلك كلمة الحق والدين، أن تنصر إخواننا المستضعفين في شتى مشارق الأرض ومغاربها، ثبت على الحق أقدامهم، وانصرهم على عدوك وأعدائهم، اغفر يا رب تقصيرنا تجاههم، وآخر دعوانا الحمد لله رب العالمين، وأقم الصلاة، إن الصلاة كانت على المؤمنين كتابا موقوتا.
الله أكبر، الله أكبر، أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله، أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله، حي على الصلاة، حي على الفلاح، قد قامت الصلاة، قد قامت الصلاة، الله أكبر، الله أكبر، لا إله إلا الله.